morning students, how are you? I hope you are keeping fine at home. Welcome to the SST class. Today I would like to discuss with you about solar and lunar eclipse. Solar means sun and then lunar means moon. So sun and moon eclipse. What is an eclipse? Our lesson begins with this important questions. What is an eclipse? Excuse me. An eclipse is the phenomena where one heavenly body comes in between the source of light, that is sun, casting its shadow on the other heavenly body. That means when the heavenly body, one heavenly body, blocks the sun rays that comes and the shadow is formed in the other heavenly body, this kind of situation, this kind of phenomena is known as eclipse. I hope it is clear to you. So, it is a phenomena, it is a situation where one heavenly body casts its shadow, or the shadow of the heavenly body falls on the other heavenly body. That is the phenomena, that is the features, that is the reality it takes place. This is the incident that takes place. So, eclipse, solar eclipse now. So, there are two eclipses. There are two eclipses. What are the two eclipses? Solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Solar eclipse means sun and the lunar means moon. So first we'll discuss about the solar eclipse. We know that the earth goes around the sun and it has got two movements. What are the two motions or the movement of the earth? One is rotation, that it rotates on its own axis, and then revolution, it goes round the sun, round the sun. While going round the sun, it also rotates on its own axis. And that is this kind of movements when it comes, and this happens that moon moves in between the sun and the earth. When the moon moves in between the sun and the earth, the solar eclipse takes place. Solar eclipse takes place. This is an eclipse of the sun. That means sun or the solar eclipse. During the solar eclipse, the moon casts its shadow. The shadow of the moon falls on the earth. On the earth. That means it blocks the source of light. And so we are not able to see the sun light. That is why it is known as solar eclipse. The eclipse cannot be seen from all the places out there. We have got very, very nice disturbance now. The birds are making noise. They are outside. They are students, so don't be disturbed with that. Let them be freely sing. Cheers. See that. So, let us come to the point. So, it is only seen, the solar eclipse can be seen only where the moon's shadow falls. Where moon's shadow is, where you can see the moon. So, solar eclipse can only be seen from where the moon's shadow is falling, not otherwise. During a solar eclipse, the moon casts two shadows. Moon forms two shadows. I have made on the board, but you might be not be clear, but you see in our diagram in the book itself that this diagrams where when it comes, the solar eclipse takes place, then the moon's shadow causes two figures. One is a dark figure, the other one is a faint figure. One dark figure dark figure is known as the umbra, and faint figure is known as the penumbra. See that? So these are the two figures. Also, sun has got the two types of eclipses. Partial means part, half of it, or little part of it, and total eclipse. So partial solar eclipse and total solar eclipse. So next, the people standing on the penumbra shadow of the moon see only the partial one, and but then those who are standing on the umbra, they can see the total solar eclipse. That is the meaning. Next one is the lunar eclipse. Next one is the lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse takes place on the full moon day, full moon night rather, full moon night. The earth blocks the sunlight when the earth comes in between the moon and the sun, and it blocks the light coming from the sun and reaching to the moon. And so we see that only a part of it. So this eclipse of the moon, this is known as moon eclipse or lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse can be seen from the earth at night, not during the day. Lunar eclipse takes place on the full moon night. There are two types of lunar eclipse, partial and total. Partial means partly it is shadow is put on the part, little part or full half part, and the total eclipse is the total means full part everywhere. So partial solar total eclipse, especially I would like to discuss with you the total solar eclipse. The earth and the moon are on the straight line. The total lunar eclipse occurs when the sun, the earth and the moon are on the straight line, and the complete moon comes under the umbral shadow comes on the earth. During the total lunar eclipse, the moon appears red in color. Why? It is because when the sun passes through the earth's atmosphere, most of its part are blue light gets scattered. So most of the blue light gets scattered or spreads spread out by the atmosphere. This makes the moon appear red or on the total solar lunar eclipse. Okay, the partial one, only part of the moon is covered by the earth's shadow, that is all partial lunar eclipse. So dear students, this is what I had to tell you, and this is a very short lesson which you can read and understand for yourself whatever we have discussed just now.